Hello friends, in this video we are going to see whenever AC supply is given to a pure capacitor, how the nature of current will be look like, and also we will see what is the power consumed by a capacitor. So see, I have drawn over here a diagram where AC voltage is given to pure capacitor C. So whenever voltage is supplied, the capacitor will charge. So let's take the applied voltage is Vm sin omega t. So charge developed through this plate is Q and given by C into V. So the charge developed is directly proportional to the voltage applied, and proportionality constant is a capacitance. So Q equal to Cv, V we have given Vm sin omega t. So I am getting Q equal to C into Vm sin omega t. Here I have assumed voltage as a reference phasor having a phase angle 0. Now we know current is rate of flow of charge. So I equal to dq by dt. So that will be derivative of Q with respect to time, and Q is given as C Vm sin omega t. So ultimately I will get I as derivative of C Vm sin omega t. C Vm is a constant, I take it outside the derivative. So I am getting C Vm derivative of sin omega t, which is nothing but cos omega t into omega. So I will write this I in terms of Vm divided by 1 by omega C into sin omega t plus pi by 2. So what I have done over here, cos omega t I have written in terms of sin as sin omega t plus pi by 2, because we know cos theta can be represented as sin theta plus pi by 2. What is the reason behind doing this? So that I can compare this equation of I with the standard equation I of t equal to Im sin omega t plus phi. Now if I compare, I will get maximum value of current Im as Vm divided by 1 over omega C and phi as pi by 2 radians or 90 degree. Now 1 over omega C I written as Xc, that I will explain in next slide. So ultimately what is the conclusion that I can draw over here? If I consider V as a reference signal starting from 0, I will get I as Im sin omega t plus 90 degree. So I can say in purely capacitive circuit, the current leads the voltage applied by pi by 2 radian or 90 degree. That is the most important conclusion that we have drawn. So suppose I want to draw waveforms, it will be like this. As I mentioned, voltage is a reference phasor or a reference signal starting from a 0, because we have considered phase angle of voltage is 0. Current flowing through the capacitor will already start before 0 degree and it will reach maximum at 0. So I can say it is started at minus pi by 2. So I can say current leads voltage by angle pi by 2 radian or 90 degree. If I draw a phasor diagram, it will be like this. Voltage is the reference along the positive x-axis direction. Current leads voltage by 90 degree, so in anticlockwise sense it will be upward along positive J axis. Now we have denoted 1 upon omega C as Xc, and that we call as capacitive reactance. So Xc is given as 1 over omega C, omega if I replace by 2 pi f, I will get Xc as 1 upon 2 pi fc, which is capacitive reactance. So let's define what is the capacitive reactance is. Okay. So in the previous slide, we have considered 1 upon omega C as Xc, and that is called as a capacitive reactance. So if I substitute 1 upon omega C as Xc, I will get Im as Vm upon Xc, and Xc will be 1 upon omega C. If I substitute omega as 2 pi f, I am getting Xc as 1 over 2 pi fc, which we call as capacitive reactance. Is defined as the opposition offered by the capacitance of a circuit to the flow of an alternating sinusoidal current. So just like an inductive reactance, it is the opposition offered by a capacitance and it's like a resistance, hence it is measured in ohms. Now let's see what is the nature of power consumed by a capacitor. So instantaneous power is given by P equal to instantaneous voltage multiplied by instantaneous current. Instantaneous voltage we have taken as Vm sin omega t, and instantaneous current that we obtain is Im sin omega t plus pi by 2, which is nothing but cos omega t. So ultimately I am getting instantaneous power as Vm Im sin omega t into cos omega t. If I adjust the two term, I will get instantaneous power as Vm Im by 2 into sin 2 omega t. So ultimately instantaneous power is a sinusoidal quantity. So I have drawn over here. So being a sinusoidal quantity, the average if I took over one complete cycle, it will be zero. So average power consumed by a capacitor is nothing but P average over a one complete cycle, integral 0 to 2 pi Vm Im by 2 into sin 2 omega t d omega t, that is nothing but 0. So what is the conclusion? Pure capacitance never consumes a power. So whenever a pure element is given, either a capacitor or an inductor, it never consumes a power. In AC circuit, the only passive element which is responsible for consumption of a power is resistance only. Capacitor and inductor never consumes a power.